Today's product review is for you that wants to automate your social media marketing, whether you're using Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, or similar. Today's tool is called Missinglettr. It's founded and developed by Benjamin Dell, who is also known for creating other awesome products like Help Desk and similar. He has also created Onboard Flow, which recently has been sold to a competitor. He's well known for his design skills, and his products are always well designed. And when you get well designed, you get an easy to use product. Missinglettr is from 2016, and I have been using it for close to a year now, so I will share my experiences with you. I first got to know Missinglettr through AppSumo. AppSumo is a marketplace for softwares where they run lifetime deals. A lot of big companies have been on this platform, like Intercom, SE Ranking, and furthermore. So sometimes the software deals goes the right way, and other times the software deals goes the wrong way. So it is a bet when you buy a deal in here, but often AppSumo really vet the different tools. So often you get a good tool and a good deal in there. I would definitely recommend you checking it out. The design is often updated within the product, and the design is great. It's not like you can't find what it is you're looking for. The onboarding process is easy. It's so easy to get started. And I will dive into the different features because there are two main features within Missinglettr. So without further ado, let's get started. Missinglettr is divided into two big modules where within these modules there are features. Their first module is their drip campaigns. The drip campaigns is basically where you make social media posts automatically. The way it works is that you enter your blog post if that's what you want to make a social media post about. What Missinglettr then does is that they scan your blog post and select different keywords that Missinglettr find relevant for you in order for you to post this on social media. The technology behind this, I couldn't get out of Benjamin. I did ask him, but he didn't want to give it up. Fair enough. But I have worked with it myself, and it's the keywords that basically control what content comes and what doesn't. So for instance, if you can imagine that it scans your blog post, and then it finds keywords that it finds relevant. When it finds a specific keyword, then it takes the sentences around that keyword, and then you get to choose whether you want to post that or not. When it's done scanning your entire blog post, then you get presented by the pictures that it has found and the different texts. You now have to plan your drip campaign. The way you do this is that you set a start date, an end date, and then you set an amount of different posts in between these dates. Missinglettr will automatically post these for you. You then choose what social media you want to post to, what profile, and what the text should be within. Missinglettr also helps you if you're missing pictures, because as we know, pictures and videos just works better on social media. So if you're missing pictures, then automatically Missinglettr generates these pictures for you containing text. You can also automatically post to Medium. There is an integration seamlessly that automatically posts to Medium if that's what you want. This is just an add-on and it's not something that you have to use. But what's important when you have set up your drip campaign is you need to follow it. For this, they have the analytics data. In here, you can see how many clicks you've gotten, where the clicks come from, what country, even what system they use on their computer and what browser they use. This is great for you to optimize and to see whether there are some social medias that you need to work more on, or is it something you need to focus less on. All this data you can find within the analytics data module. Furthermore, when you create these social media posts, you get a calculation. This calculation is based on how many possible people you're going to reach with these social media posts. It's controlled by the tags and the categories that you use. The more wide categories you use, the bigger reach you get. But the bigger reach you get, the more unspecific it gets. So I would recommend you always narrowing it in as much as you can, because a big reach is not necessarily a good thing in this case. Every time you add and remove a tag, you will see this reach count either go up or down based on what it is you're adding or removing. I have found this a little bit buggy sometimes. Often when you start creating your drip campaign, you will see that it doesn't count until you actively do something like removing a tag, adding a tag, or something similar. They also have an RSS feed integration. What this means is that, for instance, on your website, you often has an RSS feed integration with Missinglettr in this case. What it means is that Missinglettr will automatically check this RSS feed, maybe 1 hour a day or a couple of times a day, and then it will check whether there's new post, because this RSS feed contains all of your blog posts. And if Missinglettr sees there's a new blog post that is not existing in Missinglettr, automatically it will create a drip campaign for you, and all you have to do is just review it and then start it. And that's how easy it is to get started with Missinglettr's drip campaign. The other module that really sets Missinglettr apart and really puts them apart from their competitors is Curate. Curate is basically a community where you can get all of your social media posts posted on other profiles. So imagine that you have made a social media post that has generated a lot of traffic, but you want it to generate even more. What you can do is that you can, in the Curate module, post this out for everyone to use. What's so cool about Curate is that it's real people sharing your content. You have what's called a quality score. The higher your quality score is, the higher are the chances of your content getting shared. This means that the better content that you put out there, the higher your quality score will be. And the lower quality content you put out, the lower quality score you will be. For every 5 posts that you do, you get 1 credit. It's not your own post. For every 5 posts you do of the communities, then you get 1 credit, because it costs 1 credit in order for you to share your social media post in the Curate library. And trust me, it is worth it. I have so far shared 59 different posts. I have been shared 600 times, and I saw that more than 1,000 have scheduled posts about my social media post. And this is completely free. I haven't paid anything in order for this to achieve this. One pro tip is, though, the social media post that you share should never be as it's me talking. I shouldn't say an experience that I have had. You have to imagine that these are going to be shared on other people's social media profiles, so they don't want different posts talking as it's them if they don't agree in your opinion. You can get started using Missinglettr completely free. You get 1 social media account and 50 posts, and this is posts to use in your drip campaigns. If you need more, you need to upgrade to their paid plans, where you can either get 500 scheduled posts or 3,000. And then, of course, you also get more social media accounts. But start with the free plan to figure out whether this is something for you. Their support is great. When I was talking to Benjamin Dell, he answered me straight away within the same day. I've always gotten support within the same day, so there's nothing to put a finger on there. If we take a look at Missinglettr's competitors, it is Hootsuite and it's Buffer. It's the closest competitors. But the difference on these are that Hootsuite and Buffer, they only do scheduled posting. This means that they don't automatically generate content for you. They don't have the Curate library. They just focus on that you can schedule posting on your different social media profiles. However, they do have a lot more different social media profiles than Missinglettr have right now. Missinglettr has recently added Instagram as their latest addition, and I hope that we'll see Pinterest in the future. That I would personally really like, but we'll see what's in the future for Missinglettr. But when we compare those three to each other, there's no doubt that Buffer and Hootsuite has more features if we look away from the Curate library and the automatic generation. For instance, they have more extensive statistics within their social media posts, and the scheduling tools are just more extensive, but of course they also have more manpower and they have been in the industry for a longer time. If we take a look into the future of Missinglettr, they're going to add some things. I'm personally hoping for Pinterest, as mentioned, but they're going to add Google My Business, where you can easily schedule different posts to post on Google My Business. Otherwise, when I take a look at their public roadmap, it's mainly focused on helping you automating your processes around social media a lot more. And this is of course great, but I hope that they will push in some more different social medias. So that's it. That's my take on Missinglettr. So if you want to automate your social media posting and even automate the processes around it, you should try out Missinglettr. Remember, you can get started completely free, and if you find value within it, then you can always upgrade. If you have any questions about Missinglettr, please leave a comment down below and I will get back to you. Thank you so much for watching, and remember to give the video a thumbs up if you liked it. Let's catch up on the next one.